Justin Wren, class of 2005. Justin Wren has spent much of his life fighting, from a stellar early wrestling career as national champion to becoming a star UFC fighter. In his book, Fight for the Forgotten, Wren shares how God shifted his focus from fighting against opponents in the cage to fighting for the most bullied people in the world, the Mbuti Pygmies in the Dominican Republic of the Congo.
So graduating from Bishop Lynch to Congo, that's a wild journey. And I would just say that I lived my life the way I wanted to live it. And my childhood dream became a reality, but it turned into a nightmare. And it wasn't until God came in, loved the hell out of me, blessed the mess out of me, and then I spent a time in prayer, 11 months sober, and into my life with Christ. And I had a vision, and I saw the Congo, I saw the Pygmies, and 3.5 weeks later I went there. It's a life that's beyond anything I could have dreamed up for myself. It was a God-given dream.
Justin is known for his successful mixed martial arts career in the UFC. His current record of 14-2 remains an impressive testament to his skill. But many are surprised to find this 6'3", 265-pound fighter has an even bigger heart.
I've been there. I've been in a very dark, desperate place. But I would say that you have hope, to dig deep, to not give up, don't tap out. And if you do tap out, just tap out to Jesus. Say, God, I can't handle this. A lot of people say God won't give you more than you can handle. I disagree. Respectfully, I think he will give you more than you can handle so that you can give it to him when it's too much for us to handle.
After discovering his faith, following a 6-year struggle with addiction and depression in his early career, Justin stepped away from MMA to find God's purpose for his life. He soon felt called to serve the Mbuti Pygmy people deep in the jungles of the Congo. While Wren knew they were an incredibly impoverished people group, he did not know the depths of their pains until he spent time living amongst them and shared in their suffering.
And so I think that whenever you see someone suffering, you should also suffer so that you can find out the solution together. And there's a real difference in telling people what to do and then showing them how to do it.
A turning point in Justin's life was holding a young boy as he died of a water-related parasite after being refused care by local doctors.
It broke every part of me. It shattered me. Who I was completely broken. And to handle the death of a child while I'm holding him, having his blood on my hands, dig in the grave, having blisters on my hands, I was so confused. We're so lucky and comfortable and blessed to live in our little comfort zone, our American bubble, in our little Christian huddle, you know. But God's walked me through it, and I think being part of the solution, instead of trying to ignore it, instead of being indifferent, but to do something about it. And I think that's what God's always doing, is he's looking for people to partner with. You look in the Bible, and he rarely does anything on his own. He normally partners through people that love him, that want to make a difference. And so I think that's my way of coping with it. It's okay, God, this happened, but let's stop it from happening from now on.
Over the next 4 years, Justin made several trips to the Congo, with one lasting a full year for Justin to stay with the Pygmy people. He lived in the same twig and leaf huts they did, slept on the jungle floor, and immersed himself into their culture. The Pygmies gave him the name Efiosa, which means the man who loves us.
The Swahili proverb, if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go together. These guys are my heroes.
Since 2011, Justin and Fight for the Forgotten have provided nearly 3,000 acres of land and 25 water wells to the Pygmies. They have full-time staff who specialize in community development, who are working to drill new wells and teach the Pygmies farming practices. Through his book, Fight for the Forgotten, Justin is encouraging everyone to stand up for those who are bullied and persecuted.
Because I came from a place where I was so bullied and sat alone, and people hated me, and I hated myself. And then I came to this school, and I was loved and encouraged, and I was able to become a 10-time state champion in wrestling, a 5-time All-American, a 2-time national champion. I think my greatest memory at Bishop Lynch was that I was embraced. I was embraced by the teachers. They saw that I had a dream to go on and do something bigger, better with my life, and that was never discouraged. That was only encouraged.
Justin is currently working with a crew to film a documentary about his personal journey and story.